Hi everyone, this is Belal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In this video, we will create a fragment and a view model to get the movie list from our repository. So again, we will right click on our package, go to new, then select fragment from here, and then we will create a fragment with view model. So if you select this option, it will create the view model class automatically. So we will select this option, and here we will write the fragment name, that is, let's say movies fragment. This is the layout file name and this is our view model. Hit on finish and it will create all the three files. So we have our view model, we have our fragment, and we have our layout file, which is movies fragment. Inside the layout file, we will create a simple recycler view. So this is the recycler view and it is match parent. And I will give the ID as recycler view movies. So this is our recycler view where we are going to display our list. Then we will go to movies fragment and actually we do not need these for now. So I will delete everything except on create view. Yeah. So let's delete everything. So we have a very simple fragment. But in this video, we will not work on fragment. We will do it in the next video. In this video, we will work on our movies view model. So the point is, this view model will communicate with our movies repository. So we need an instance of this movies repository inside our movies view model class. So what I'll do is I will pass this movies repository inside the constructor of this movies view model. So here I will write private val repository of type movies repository. Then inside the movies view model, first I will define a private val and I will name it movies, and it is mutable live data of type list of type movie. So we have our mutable live data. Now we should not expose the mutable live data outside the class. So that is why it is made private. Now I will define one more live data that will be exposed outside the class, but this is live data that cannot be changed. So that is why we defined mutable live data as private, and then I'm defining live data as public, that is accessible outside the class. So we have val and then I will name it movies, so both having the same name. So what I will do is I will put an underscore for this movies, which is private. So we have movies, and the type of this movies is live data, and again the type is list of type movie. And then to this movies we will define a getter. So we can simply use get equals to, and when we will get this movies we will return this underscore movies. So we have mutable live data to make the changes, and then we are exposing outside live data that cannot be changed. So this is a good practice to do. Now we will create a suspending function, that is suspend fun, and then we have get movies, and we will write repository dot get movies. So we are just calling our get movies function that will fetch all the movies from the API, and we will store it here. Val movies equals to repository dot get movies. Then we will put this movies to our mutable live data. So we will write underscore movies dot value equals to movies. So right now we are referring to this movies, not this. Okay, this movies is local to this function. So we have our function getMovies. Now we can call this function from our fragment. So let's create the override function on activity created that we just deleted here. So we will write override fun on activity created, and inside this function we will initialize the view model. But the point is, we initialize view model like this: view model equals to view model providers dot off, and then we pass the fragment and then we get the view model. We do not initialize the view model like movies view model. We don't do like this. But the problem here is, we are having a parameter, a constructor parameter for our movies view model. So how do we pass the parameter? That is not possible like this when we are creating the view model instance like this. So in this case, when we want to pass a parameter to our view model, we create a view model factory that is responsible for creating the view model instances. So what we will do is, we will create one more class inside our package Kotlin file class, and we will name it movies view model factory. And here we will create a class movies view model factory, and to this class we can pass private val repository of type movies repository. And to this class we will inherit view model provider dot new instance factory like this. And inside this class we can override a function which is override fun view model create, and here we can return movies view model, and we will pass this repository and we will return it as t, and we can add this unchecked cast like this. So we have our movies view model factory. Now this factory will return us the movies view model that will have repository as the parameter, or this movies view model will have the repository instance. So come back to movies fragment, and here first we will create our movies view model factory instance. So here we will write private late init var factory of type movies view model factory. Then first we need to initialize the factory. So we will write factory equals to movies view model factory, and we will pass the repository here. So we also need to initialize the repository. So we will write val repository equals to movies repository, and to the repository we need to pass API. So we need the API as well. So we have val API equals to movies API like this. So we have the API. To the repository we will pass API, and to the factory we will pass repository like this. Then we can create the view model instance. So we will write here view model providers dot off, and we will pass the fragment and the factory, and then we will write get, and we will pass our view model class which is movies view model class dot java, and we have the view model. Now with the help of this view model we can call the function that is get movies, but we will do it on the next video. I hope you got the point that how to create a view model factory and view model, and how to work with live data inside view model. In case you have any problem or confusion, feel free to comment it below and I will help you out, because this is the very important thing that you need to understand the MVVM architecture. And finally, if you like this video, then please hit on that like button, subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends. So thanks for watching everyone. This is Belal Khan now signing off.